This is Channel 8 WMTW, Maine's total weather news coverage.
Good afternoon and thanks for joining us today. I'm Tracy Sable.
And I'm Steve Minnick. We are following breaking news this afternoon. A Maine State trooper killed this morning while on the job.
Police say the trooper was investigating a crash on the southbound side of I-95 in Hamden, just south of Bangor, when he was hit by another vehicle. The trooper was killed near the Coldbrook Road overpass. That is exit 180. WMTW News HM Keithley is live now near the crash site in Hamden with what we know so far. Jim.
Well, good afternoon. So people around these parts know this area as the Dysart's exit because of the Dysart's truck stop. That's where we are right now. You see the southbound ramp onto I-95 is closed. A 10-mile stretch between mile marker 180 and 170. That's where that accident scene is still being investigated right now. Here's what we know. A Maine State trooper was out of his cruiser tending to a disabled car about 7:30 this morning. I-95 southbound in Hamden. That's where he was. We're told that a tractor trailer was also involved in this crash. Exactly how, police are still trying to figure that out. The trooper was rushed to Eastern May Medical Center by ambulance. That's in Bangor, and that is where he died. His name is not being released at this time. Police are planning a 3 o'clock briefing to update us on this crash. We will likely learn the identity of the trooper at that time and other details. Also, whether weather was a factor. As you can see, it's snowing up here, so that may have been a factor in this crash as well. So we'll bring all of that to you as we get it. Follow us online and tonight beginning at 4 o'clock. For now, we're live in Hamden. Jim Keithley, WMTW News 8.
All right, thank you so much, Jim. Well, some more information to share now. The last Maine State Police trooper death was Glenn Strange. That was back in 1997. He died from a heart attack a few days after being punched in the chest following a pursuit. There have been 11 state police line of duty deaths here in Maine.
Now, Jim mentioned that 3 o'clock news conference. We will carry that live here on Channel 8. That is when state police will shed more light on this trooper and this morning's incident. And remember to keep your push notifications turned on for any more breaking news about this story.
This is Channel 8 WMTW, Maine's total weather news coverage.
It's been a tragic day for the Campbell family with the loss of Detective Ben Campbell. And it's been a tough day for our agency. We've lost one of our very best, and we've certainly lost one of Maine's very best.
Tragedy in Maine. State police confirming today one of their own, Detective Ben Campbell, has been killed in an accident. Good evening. Thanks for joining us tonight at 5. I'm Steve Otari.
And I'm Tracy Sable. It happened this morning on I-95 in Hamden while he was out of his vehicle. WMTW News 8's Mary-Kate Mannion is live now in Bangor with more about who Detective Campbell was. Mary-Kate.
The flags are flying here at half staff at Eastern Maine Medical Center, which is where Detective Ben Campbell's body was taken after what the state colonel called a freak accident this morning on the highway. Those who knew him say that he had a textbook smile and he was just 5 days shy of his 32nd birthday. Now, he grew up in East Hampton, Massachusetts. That's in Western Mass. He graduated from Westfield State before joining the state police here in Maine in 2012. He was then promoted 3 years ago to a member of the polygraph unit. He lived here in Maine in Millinocket with his wife, Hillary, and their 6-month-old son, Everett.
We'll honor Ben moving forward. This will be a day that every member of this agency remembers. These are our friends, our colleagues, our classmates, and it cuts deep.
And at this moment, we are told that both Mass and Maine State Police troopers are helping to escort some of Detective Campbell's relatives from Massachusetts up here to the hospital. They'll be able to visit with him before his body is transported down to Augusta later tonight. We're told that there'll be a procession, and of course, we hope to bring that to you as it happens. But for right now, live in Bangor, I'm Mary-Kate Mannion for WMTW News 8.
Thank you. And the crash happening on I-95 in Hamden is... The trooper was trying to help a disabled car on the side of the highway. For more on exactly what happened, we go to WMTW News 8's Jim Keithley, who continues our total team coverage live in Bangor. Jim.
Steve, being described as a freak accident here on the highway this morning that claimed the life of what they're calling one of their best. Here is what happened. We want to show you the video that we have. 31-year-old Detective Ben Campbell was responding to a slide-off on Interstate 95 in the southbound lane in Hamden this morning at 7:30. That's just south of Bangor. The road conditions were slick. It was snowing at the time. He was out of his cruiser assisting the person in the car that had just gone off the road when police say a logging truck passed by. Here's what happened next.
Two wheels separated from the tractor trailer as it approached Detective Campbell and that vehicle. One of those wheels rolled harmlessly into the median. The other wheel rolled and struck Detective Campbell as he was outside of his vehicle in the breakdown lane.
And the detective was rushed by ambulance to Eastern Maine Medical Center, where he was pronounced dead there. A commercial vehicle unit here at the State Police, they've got their own team that will conduct what they call a vehicle autopsy on that logging truck to figure out exactly what went wrong with that. The driver, we're told, is cooperating. The person in the car that Detective Campbell was had stopped to help was not injured, but the colonel here said that that person did witness this horrific accident. Again, a very emotional and upsetting day in Bangor, here at the barracks in Bangor near the airport. And that is the news as we have it at this point. We'll have more for you throughout the evening. For now, we're live in Bangor. Jim Keithley, WMTW News 8.
All right, thank you, Jim. As state police investigate what happened this morning, Maine's law enforcement community is coming together and mourning the loss of one of their own. WMTW News 8's Tyler Catterat is live now along 95 and Gray with what they're saying. Tyler?
Tracy, simply put, they are at a loss. They say this is the worst example of how a seemingly normal day can turn in an instant. For law enforcement, working along the side of the highway is routine, much like the video that you are seeing here from 95, but they do face danger every time they step out of those cars. They say that what happened today is a somber reminder of that. This is now the state's third line of duty death for a first responder in less than a year. That's weighing heavily on everyone's minds as they try to process the loss of Detective Campbell.
I mean, we're coming up on the first anniversary of Corporal Cole's death, the tragic incident with Captain Barnes, and now this. You know, hopefully it's over, but the reality is that, you know, I think first responders know when they go out that they've got to be careful.
We're all one big family, really, and when something like this happens, we're all sad for the person that passed away and also their families.
It's important to note that while what happened today appears to be a freak accident, law enforcement does say that some of the risks like speeding and distracted driving, those are avoidable if people just slow down and take a minute to think about what they're doing behind the wheel. Also important to note that next week is actually National Work Zone Awareness Week. Some important things to take note of again this evening. Live along 95, Tyler Catterat, WMTW News 8.
While taking a look now at some of the other officers who have made the ultimate sacrifice.
It begins back in October of 1997. Detective Glenn Strange suffered a heart attack after he was punched in the chest following a pursuit. Strange served with the Maine State Police for 3 years.
And in April of 1996, Trooper James Drew Griffith was killed after his patrol car was struck by an ice truck. He was making a U-turn when that truck hit his car on the driver's side door. Griffith served for 10 years.
In November 1994, Trooper Jeffrey Perola was killed in a car accident when he was responding to a domestic dispute involving guns. He later died at the hospital. Perola was with the state police for 5 years.
And in January 1990, Lieutenant Rene Albert Goupil suffered a heart attack after finishing a mandatory 2-mile run while on duty. He was a Marine Corps vet and was with the Maine State Police for 20 years. And we have total coverage of the story inside of our WMTW app and WMTW.com. Make sure you check back throughout the week as we learn more about Detective Campbell and details about services to remember him.
Ben Campbell had been with the state police for the past 7 years. He lived in Millinocket with his wife and new baby.
His family is now with the body at Eastern Maine Medical Center in Bangor. WMTW News 8's Mary Kate Mannion is there now with more on Campbell's life. Mary Kate.
Well, Steve, like so many other places here in the state of Maine, the flags are flying at half staff here at Eastern Maine Medical Center. And just a little while ago, traffic was stopped and it was a moving sight here. If you take a look, this is the procession of Maine State Police as well as some Massachusetts State Police troopers who were escorting some of Detective Campbell's family members from Massachusetts up here to the hospital in Bangor where his remains are being kept. And several of those state police troopers that were a part of that procession are remaining here close by the hospital. We're told that they will be escorting Campbell's body to the Maine Medical Examiner's office down in Augusta later on this evening.
This is Channel 8 WMTW, Maine's total weather news coverage.
We've lost one of our very best, and we've certainly lost one of Maine's very best.
Maine's law enforcement community honoring the life of Detective Ben Campbell. Campbell was killed after he was hit by a tire that fell off of a truck along Interstate 95 this morning. Detective Campbell was hit while helping a driver whose car had slid off the road in the morning snow.
He is the first Maine State Trooper to die in the line of duty in 22 years. Our solo coverage continues tonight in Augusta, where WMTW News 8's Tyler Catterett has a look at the dangers facing Maine State Troopers.
But we begin with Mary Kate Mannion at the State Medical Examiner's Office, where that emotional procession just finished. Mary Kate.
Well, Megan and Steve, the head of the state police in Maine say that Detective Ben Campbell was one of Maine's best, and that is the reason why he stopped to help that car that was spun out on I-95 this morning and earlier tonight. You could really see just how beloved he was within the department as so many men and women in blue showed up here as his remains were brought to Augusta along with some firefighters as well. Here's a look at that procession. As I mentioned, it went from Bangor, where his remains were taken from a hospital there, down here to the chief medical examiner's office in Augusta. State police say that just after 7:30 this morning, a logging truck was passing by that spun out car where Detective Campbell was assisting. It lost two of its tires. One of them went into the median. The other ended up hitting the detective. Detective Campbell did grow up in East Hampton, Massachusetts. He graduated from Westfield State University and joined the state police in 2012 here in Maine. He was later promoted as a detective with the polygraph unit. He lived in Millinocket with his wife Hillary and their six-month-old son Everett.
He was so proud and loved her so much, and he introduced you to her, and you'd think he'd just won the lottery. He took such great pride in his marriage, in his new son, and he was a guy that was always going to see the good in people, and he was a great polygraph examiner because people would talk to him, and he cared, and that's why he stopped today.
And the driver of that logging truck also stopped, and he is cooperating with police. We're told that an autopsy of sorts is being done on that logging truck to find out how those two tires did come away. And again, his family has requested for a funeral with full police honors. Once we have more information on that, we will be sure to pass that along to you as well. Reporting live in Augusta tonight, I'm Mary Kate Mannion for WMTW News 8.
People lining overpasses along I-95 from Bangor to Augusta tonight. Take a look, hanging flags and signs to honor Detective Campbell as his procession made its way through.
This is Channel 8 WMTW, Maine's total weather news coverage.
A somber journey home for Detective Ben Campbell as Maine State Police honor one of their own. The outside community offering support as the procession makes its way back home to Millinocket.
I'm Jim Keithley. Coming up, we're going to have more about the driver of that logging truck involved in the crash and also the vehicle autopsy now underway.
First responders from across the state of Maine are honoring Detective Ben Campbell.
That's right. In a show of solidarity, police and fire crews standing watch today during another procession that happened this afternoon. WMTW News 8's Mary Kate Mannion joins us live now from Augusta. Mary Kate.
Yeah, Tracy and Steve, certainly a show of support. And state police shared just a little while ago that they are just so heartbroken at the loss of Detective Ben Campbell, but that they are just overwhelmed with the outpouring of support that they received. And you could certainly tell that with that procession that took place earlier today. Take a look at this. Police and fire crews from across the state got together today as Detective Campbell's remains were taken back to his home of Millinocket from the state medical examiner's office to a funeral home there. Detective Campbell lived there with his wife, Hillary, and six-month-old son, Everett. The head of the state police says that Detective Campbell had a textbook smile and was so well-liked amongst all of the barracks. Augusta Fire did take part in today's procession. They say it's very important for first responders to come together, especially during a time of loss. And this one does come just a few weeks after another first responder, Captain Joel Barnes, also died on duty while fighting a fire.
Well, we're all, in public safety, we're all one big family, and law enforcement supports us in our time of need as they did a few weeks ago when we lost one of ours, and we're just doing the paying our same respects to them and to the family of Detective Campbell.
And Detective Campbell's family has said that they would like to have a full police honor at his funeral. Those are still being planned, and once we know more on the arrangements, we'll be sure to share that with you. Reporting live in Augusta, I'm Mary Kate Mannion for WMTW News 8.
All right, thank you, Mary Kate. Meanwhile, we are learning more about the driver of the logging truck involved in that crash that killed Detective Ben Campbell along Interstate 95 in Hampden yesterday. WMTW News 8's Jim Keithley is live now in Augusta. And Jim, we're told that you went through some of the truck's records today.
So a vehicle autopsy is now underway, we're told, by investigators with the state police, a commercial division, at an undisclosed location. Those investigators are trying to figure out why those two wheels came flying off that logging truck in the first place, one of them striking and killing Detective Ben Campbell. The driver of the logging truck involved in the crash that killed Detective Ben Campbell is the sole owner and operator of his own company, Scott Willett Trucking, out of Patton in northern Maine. The Federal Motor Carrier Safety Administration keeps detailed inspection reports on commercial vehicles, and here's what we found in regards to Willett's vehicle. There were 7 violations just 5 months ago that included steering system components that were worn, welded, or missing. It also found tire ply or belt material exposed, and the tire tread depth was less than it should be. An earlier inspection back in June of last year found some of the same tire tread problems and also an excessive weight violation. Well, that's vehicle carrying more than 5,000 pounds over the allowable weight. The report does not indicate whether the issues were repaired, and the report also says that Willett has no unsafe driving violations. Now, State Police spokesman Steve McCausland says that they will look into Willett's driving records, also those inspection reports, but right now their primary focus is on the physical truck itself, and he says that they do not expect that vehicle autopsy to be completed today. We're live in Augusta. Jim Keithley, WMTW News 8.